Welcome to this Excel Basics video tutorial. Being best at Excel is one of the most valuable skills you can offer to your employer or your team members. In this tutorial, I will be showing you the very basics of Excel that you need to know in order to get started with Excel. There are some slight differences in various Excel versions, but most parts you will be learning in this video will be applicable even if you are using the older or a newer version than the one I am using. My basic profession is mechanical engineering, and I have been using Excel for the last 20 years. And as a beginner, you might be thinking why Excel is so important in this modern workplace environments. And the reason is that Excel provides an extensive set of features for managing and analyzing data. So when you click on Excel icon on your computer, you will be presented with this screen. On the right hand side, you see all the files which you have recently opened in Excel program. On the left hand side, you have new, where you can start a new document, open, where you can open any document from existing files from your computer. You have to click on this PC. It will show you all the folders in your computer. Similarly, you can open a document from your online storage, and then you can save and save as a document when you finish. So these are the items on the left hand side. So if you want to open a new document, then you will be presented with a bunch of templates. You can use any of these templates if you wish, but as a beginner, we will be using a blank document, and the Excel document is called workbook. If you click on this workbook, then you will be presented with this blank workbook. On the left hand side at the bottom, you can see this is sheet 1. So this area is called sheet or a spreadsheet. It has columns, as you can see, A, B, C, and there are a large number of columns. After Z, and if you click on this arrow here, you can see that after Z, it starts AA, AB, and so on. The rows are number 1, 2, 3, as you can see on the left-hand side. You can have thousands of rows and columns, more than you might ever need. So don't worry about the exact number. It keeps increasing in every new version. But if you do want to see, so just press and hold Control and press down arrow. So as you can see that there are large number of rows. You can see this number here. So these many rows are available to you. So in order to go back, press and hold Control and then press up arrow. So you will be at row 1. So if you want to see what is the last column, then you just press and hold Control and right arrow. So this will be the last column. And there are about 16,000 or so columns available to you. So you might never need this much rows and columns, but Excel provides this to you. So in order to go back, just press and hold Control and left arrow, and you will be at column 1. So at the top, you can see that there are many tabs available. File, I have already shown you. Home is the tab where most of your time will be spent. This whole area is called ribbon. And as you can see, there are lines, these gray lines in between. So all these icons within these lines are one group of commands. So these are Excel commands. So this is one group. Similarly, this group of command is one group, and the intersection of any column and a row is called a cell. So I am here on the first cell, and in Excel, every cell has a name. So the way we name this cell is that first we put the name of the column and then the number of the row. So this cell has a name A1. Similarly, this has a name B1. And if I put my cursor here, so this cell has a name G11. The next thing you want to know is the range in Excel. So whenever you select more than one cell, let's say I select these two cells. Now this will become a range, and this range also has a name because there are only two cells in this range, but there could be a ranges like this. So this range has a top left cell, which is H4. And the right bottom cell, which is N13. So this range, the name of this range will be H4:N13. H4:N13 is the name of this range. When you are putting data in Excel, Technically, it doesn't matter whether you put the data in columns or in rows, but before you start putting your data in this Excel sheet, you should plan your data entry. There are no hard and fast rules, but there are certain things which you will learn with experience that putting certain kind of data in columns and certain kind of data in rows is always useful. So let us take one example. This is a simple table. In this table, we have few courses, the price of a course, and then the number of courses sell in every month. So this is just an example. These are not real numbers. So the purpose of this example is just to show you how to edit cells and these type of things. One thing you should note is you almost always never have to type all the data in your Excel. There are many features you can use and you can avoid typing. You can speed up the process of data entry if you know the commands. So assume that we have to enter this data. So there are a few things which you have to type, because this data will not be in the Excel sheet in the beginning. You might have this data on your diary or on your some other record. So there are a few ways to bring data direct into the Excel sheet, but that we will be discussing later on. Let's assume that you have this data written somewhere on your diary and you have to enter this in your Excel sheet. But there are a few things which you cannot avoid and you have to type. For example, in this data, I have these course names, then the prices and all these number of sales you have to copy from some websites where these courses are being sold, and then you have to enter in Excel. But there are few things you can quickly automate. For example, these six numbers, you can just place them very quickly. Similarly, if your data has months, January, February, then you can quickly place these months as well. So let us assume that we have all this data typed. So I just copy this and I paste it here. Pasting, just right click, and when you paste, there are a lot of options to paste. So if you use the first one, it will keep the formatting of this data. If you use the second one, it will not keep the formatting. So the other things we will discuss in next videos, but for this video, we will be using this first option. So I just paste this data. So let us see how to enter these numbers. So you just type the first number one, then at the lower right hand side, you can see this little dot. And when you hover over this dot, you will see this plus. Now what you do is you press Control and keep it pressed. Now you press the left mouse button and keep it pressed as well. And now you drag up to the last row. And now you first release the mouse button, left mouse button, and then you release the control, and now these numbers will be entered. And now for these months, you just place your cursor here and type JAN, the first month, and then you simply drag this plus sign. When you hover near this corner, it will become plus. You just press the left mouse button and keep it pressed, and then drag this, and all the months will be added. As you can see that there is some formatting going on here. Just click on the first cell above January and you type sales, paste 2019. And now you notice that these four columns are combined into one column. So in order to do that, you just select these four columns, and then one way to combine is to press merge and center. Just press this and this will be combined. And then you can of course make them bold and increase the font size in order to match this one. Now the other way to combine is, if I press Control Z to undo this thing, the other way to combine is select all these, and then on the right hand side in this group, in this cells group, you have a command format. Click on format. At the very end, there is format cells, and then this dialog box will appear, and then you have to check this merge cells. So this will merge the cells. If I press OK here, these are merged, but the text is on the left hand side. In order to put the text in the middle, in the same dialog box, you have horizontally centered and vertically bottom. So you have to select centered in both horizontal and vertical. Horizontal center, vertically center, and then OK. Now the text will be centered both horizontally and vertically. So this is how you merge cells. In order to increase the size of the rows, you just hover over the row until you see this double-sided arrow, and then you just drag this. This will increase the size of the row. Similarly, to increase the size of the column, you hover over the column until you see this double-sided arrow, and then you drag towards right. Column size will increase. Now, for example, I type a long text here. Let's say I type, this is the sale figure of April. As you can see here, that it seems that this text is going into the second cell, but actually it is not. All this text is still in the first cell from where we started this text. And the way you can check it, either you can drag this and you can see that this whole text is in one cell, or if you click on this cell and then you see here at the top, you will see that all this text is in this cell. And if you want to edit this text, if you click on this and start typing, for example, D, you will see that the text disappeared, because when you start typing over this text, it removes the previous text. So if you want to just edit this text, let me do Ctrl Z to undo. If you want to edit this text, so there are two ways. One is you click on this text and then click on this top bar wherever you want to put something. Just click and a cursor will appear, and then you can type anything you want. The second way to edit is you quickly double click on this cell. If you quickly double click, again a cursor will be inserted in this cell and then you can edit. This is how you edit this cell. So now let us delete this. Now these things you have to, of course, type. So I just copy. Again, I can paste here. If I use this second option, 1, 2, 3 is written here. This paste option will not keep the formatting. It will paste the text in simple words. But the first option will keep the formatting intact. So therefore, I'm using first option. Now we have to bold these as well. So just select these and press the bold, and you can also increase the font size. Now these three things we have to copy, of course. And as you can see that now I am pasting these three columns. So where I want to click paste on the first cell, I right click and paste. So it will keep the text in three columns. So this is how you can paste if you are pasting text from more than one columns. And when you finish, then you can save it by going into File and Save As, and then you can give it a name and it will be saved. If you want to save to a particular folder, then you press on this browse, and then on your computer, wherever you want to save, you can save this file. Now, one more thing which is most commonly used is, if for example, I have some text here and I press enter, my cursor will go to the next row. If I want to go to the next column, then I have to press tab. And when you press tab, you go to the next column. When you press enter, you go to the next row. And if you want to go back, for example, you go tab to the next column, then if you press shift tab, you come back. So this is how you browse into columns and rows. Just keep in mind that when you press enter, you go to the next row, not to the next column. If you want to change the color of the text, you click here and you can choose any color. If you want to change the background of the text, then you click on this and you can change the background of the text. If text is too long, for example, this text is, let's say anything is too long, but you don't want to go to the next column. You want all your text to stay and look in this column. Then you press this wrap text, and it will show all the text in that one cell by increasing the height of the row. Now the last thing I want to show is that, for example, this column is occupying a lot of space. If I want this column to have the appropriate space which is required for this word price, then what I will do, I will click on this border of this column and the next column, and when I see this double-sided arrow, I quickly double click. Now this column will be just enough wide to accommodate the most lengthy word in this column, which is price. And if you want to do this for all these columns, then you select all of those and then just double click anywhere, and it will resize to the just enough width. So this is it for this video. I hope that you find this video useful.